Hey everyone! Now in this video I'll be explaining car engines. Now I know for a lot of my subscribers this will probably be just mostly review, but I want to have a starting point where if someone comes in new, they can have a good way of getting into seeing how cars work. So this is that way. And so we're going to talk about engines and how they work. So first I'm just going to go through pretty much all the components within the engine, and then I'll talk about how they work together. So just starting at the top, we've got fuel injectors which spray fuel into your intake manifold. We've got a camshaft. That's responsible for opening valves that allow air to go in or out of the cylinder. We've got rocker arms which connect the camshaft to the valves. We've got these valves here which open and close, allowing air to come in or go out depending on which side. We've got the cylinder here, so depending on what kind of engine you have, V8, V6, that's how many cylinders you have. 6 cylinders for a V6, 8 cylinders for a V8. So we've got a piston here. This is what moves up and down. And you turn this vertical motion into rotational motion in order to move your car. We've got the connecting rod, which connects the piston to the crankshaft. We've got the crankshaft, which is connected to all of the different pistons within the engine, and so they all supply that torque to this rod. And then we've got a spark plug, which ignites the air-fuel mixture, which you put in. So for this video, we're going to be looking at a 4-stroke gasoline engine. It's pretty much the most common here in America, so that's why I chose it. So, alright, how does all this work? Well, you've got 4 strokes, so I'm going to go through each of these and explain what's happening here. So your first stroke is intake. So when you have your intake stroke, this valve here, your exhaust, is going to be closed. This camshaft is going to be rotated enough so that this valve is pushed open. There's a little spring here that it compresses and it opens this valve. When it's compressed, when that's pressed down, this piston is going to be at the top and it's going to be moving down. So as that piston moves down, it's going to pull in an air-fuel mixture into this cylinder. So that air-fuel mixture comes from the fuel injector and then the air coming in from your intake. So that's going to be the first step, is just pulling in that air-fuel mixture into this cylinder chamber. So this piston will be all the way down here at the bottom. Now your next step is compression. So for compression, both of these valves will be closed. This camshaft will be rotated in a manner that neither of these are open. So you can see there's a little lobe here, and it rotates about this center dot. So it's only open when the camshaft is pointed toward those. Otherwise, they're going to remain closed. So both of these valves are closed and our piston is down here at the bottom. Now, the next step is compression. So that piston is going to move back up. And as it moves back up, it's going to compress the air and the fuel that have been put into inside of the cylinder. Now, finally, we get our power stroke. So once that piston gets all the way up to the top, a spark ignites and you have a little explosion that occurs in here as that fire spreads. And it forces that piston back down to the bottom. Now you've got just exhaust gases in here. You've burnt up all the oxygen. There's no oxygen remaining if you've burnt it perfectly. And so you want to get rid of that air. So this camshaft here will rotate and push in this rocker arm. And so this will open up this valve. And as the piston comes back up, it pushes out the exhaust gas out of this the headers here. So that's the final step. So once again, let's just go through those real quickly. Intake, you're pulling in the air and the fuel. That cylinder, that piston moves down. Compression, you're just squeezing all that air and fuel mixture into a very small space. Power stroke, you ignite that air-fuel mixture and it pushes the piston down, providing a torque on the crankshaft. And then exhaust, you want to get that air squeezed back out so the piston moves back up and pushes out the remaining exhaust. And then the cycle just repeats itself and goes on and on and on. So let's look at the big picture. So here we've got a basic 2-cylinder engine connected to a crankshaft. So what happens after you've supplied that torque to the crankshaft? Well, that torque helps rotate a flywheel which is connected to the crankshaft, and that flywheel maintains momentum and keeps the engine running smooth, and it is attached to a clutch if you're in a manual car, or torque converter if you're in an automatic car. Now, that then passes to a transmission, depending automatic or manual transmission, and then so you'll have gears in there that change up the speeds and the torque passing through, and then ultimately you pass that torque to a drive shaft. Now the drive shaft sends the torque to a differential which splits the torque between the left and right tires. Now this can go either in the front or the back. In this drawing here, I've got it going to the rear wheels. So these rear wheels are driving, and so then ultimately that torque passes to these two wheels, they rotate, and the car moves forward. So that's the general idea of a car engine and how it moves you. Now I've got topics on all of these in much greater detail and different types. So you can go in and look at those and understand all of this much better. But this is a great starting point to just see the general picture of how it all works. And then from there you can get into more detail of, say, a clutch or a torque converter, different transmissions, and, you know, flywheel, the engine, different types of engines, suspension setups, everything. So it's a great starting point if you understand all this. And probably the next video that you should watch after this would be diesel versus gasoline, and that'll explain the strokes in more detail and how a diesel engine differs from a gasoline engine.